Good morning, students. Priyanka Sharma this side. I'm again here with a new video of your chapter from civics. In the earlier video, we discussed the first part of the parliamentary form of government, in which we discussed about the Lok Sabha and the Indian Parliament and its components, Lok Sabha, its compositions, and sessions, the speaker, and its functions. Now, in the part 2 of the video, I am going to discuss the another part which was left. It was Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is also a part of the parliament. So let's start with the Rajya Sabha. Composition. Composition means how Rajya Sabha formed or how it works. The Rajya Sabha of the parliament is the upper house. Basically, Lok Sabha is the lower house and the Rajya Sabha is the upper house of the parliament. It represents the states of India. That is why it is called the councils of states. Lok Sabha represents central government or union government in which MPs work. But Rajya Sabha represents states in which the ministers of the or the MLAs came from the different states like Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Delhi, or other Uttarakhand. Other many states are there, 28 states are there. From there, the MLAs came and formed Rajya Sabha. The members of Rajya Sabha are not elected by president people directly. Rajya Sabha, in Rajya Sabha, the representatives are not elected directly. They are elected indirectly by the legislative assemblies by various of various states. Indirectly, they are selected by legislative assemblies. That is why the MLAs are called. The Rajya Sabha is permanent house. It cannot be dissolved. Rajya Sabha is a permanent house. Lok Sabha dissolve, as I told you, Lok Sabha dissolve after every 5 years, and again elections are occur there. But Rajya Sabha is a permanent house in which the period of Rajya Sabha is 6 years, and the 1/3 of its members. 1/3 means 1/3 of the total members. Okay, total means the total member are whatever the members number of the members in the Rajya Sabha, in which 1/3 of the total member retires every after every 2 years. So in 6 years there is 3 times retirement of the members. In that is why this is the permanent house, never dissolved. Members at present there are 245 members in the Rajya Sabha. 233 are elected from the state and UTs, in which 245 total members are in Rajya Sabha, and in which 233 are elected from states and union territories, UTs, or 12 members are nominated by president directly. President elect 12 or nominate 12 members according to him. They these 12 members belongs to the different categories like science, art and architecture. They are the most respectful people of our country. Now, qualification to be a member of Rajya Sabha. So here is the qualification, who could be or who may be a member of Rajya Sabha. He or she should be a citizen of India. He should or she should have citizenship of India. This is must. She should or he should be at least 30 years of age. Its age, their age should be 30 years or more. Should not bankrupt or mentally unstable. They should not be bankrupt or mentally unstable. They should be mentally healthy. Not hold any government job. They should not be on any post of the government or any government salary. They should not be able, or they are not taking any government salary. Presiding officer. Who is the presiding officer of the Rajya Sabha? In Rajya Sabha, the presiding officer, the president, we can say the chairperson, is Vice President of India. Vice President of India is the chairperson of the राज्यसभा. और राइट नाउ वेंकैया नायडू इज अवर वाइस प्रेसिडेंट एज वेल एज द प्रेजाइडिंग ऑफिसर ऑफ राज्यसभा. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. वेंकैया नायडू इज आर वाइस प्रेसिडेंट. नीड ऑफ अ पार्लियामेंट. नाउ व्हाट डू यू थिंक व्हाई वी नीड अ पार्लियामेंट. पार्लियामेंट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट आई थिंक. सो व्हाई डू वी नीड अ पार्लियामेंट. फर्स्ट इज इट हैज़ बेसिकली मैनी फंक्शंस. अ पार्लियामेंट इज हैविंग मैनी फंक्शंस विच शुड बी विच इज मस्ट फॉर अवर कंट्री. बेसिकली द फर्स्ट फंक्शन वी कैन डिस्कस हेयर इज legislative function. What is legislative? I told you, I think earlier classes also, legislative is the highest law making body. So parliament do the first very important work is law making. Parliament makes laws with the help of legislative council. The parliament is the highest law making body of our country. Parliament is the highest law making body. It is highest law making body. It makes the laws. Parliament has power to make laws on 97 subjects. Parliament has power. It can make laws on 97 subjects. 97 subjects are under the parliament, which comes under union list. 66 subjects of state list. For the states, there are 66 subjects which parliament makes laws for a state, and 47 subjects of concurrent list. Concurrent list is comes under the power of 97 union list and subjects. These are the subjects. 47 subjects are those subjects which we can make laws for a state as well as the union government. Both these subjects work for those union and state. This is called concurrent list. So keep it in your mind that 97 subjects comes under the union list, 66 subjects comes under the state list, and 47 subjects come under the union and state both. That is why it's called concurrent list. I hope this is clear. Approval by the majority of state legislatures. The parliament alone has the right to amend the constitution. Only parliament is having a right to do changes in the constitution. Bringing change or making any change in the constitution is a long process, but the right is only parliament having. Parliament is only have the right to change in the constitution. Nobody can change. Not our prime minister, not our president can change the laws and anything, amendment or changes in the constitution. Only parliament do, after a long procedure of the passing the act or bills, it becomes a law and add to the constitution. This is called amendment. Now, control over national finance. Control over the national finance means the every issues related with money. Every issue related with money from a nation. This is called national finance. So parliament also controls over the national finance. Parliament passes all the annual budget. Every year a budget passes, or every 4 years. There have every 5 years in of the Lok Sabha, it keeps check on the annual budget or national finance. The parliament pass all the annual budget. Annual means hota hai every year. Annual means every year. That is why annual budget this is called. The parliament pass all the annual budget in the union government every year in the month of March and April. Judicial powers. Judicial powers means the judgmental powers, or the powers which given to the judges is directly related with the parliament. It can impeach. Impeach means a process of charging them with the guilt or crime. It can impeach the president. Parliament can impeach the president and vice president and the judges of Supreme Court and High Court. Parliament have right to impeach. Impeach to impeach means to remove from the post. Impeach means a process from which we change any person due to their guilt. Guilt means their fault or their crime. If president or our prime minister or our vice president or judges are caught with the guilt or crime, if they do any kind of crime or guilt, parliament have right to remove them from their post. This is called impeachment process. I hope this is clear. Now, another function of the parliament is control over the executive government. Now, parliament also controls over the executive government. First of all, let me explain you what is executive. As earlier I have explained everything, but still I am explaining this again. First of our parliament body have three main functions. First is legislature, another is executive, or third one is judiciary. So legislature is, it's a highest law making body. Legislature makes law for the country. Executive, responsible for execution or implementing the laws. Any law which is made by legislature is implemented by executive. Executives ke andar hamare sare aate hain ministers. Every minister who works for the country is the part of executive. Every minister, like if they are MLAs, they are MPs, prime minister, vice president, all the ministers are called and comes under the executive, and they are responsible for execution or implementation of the law. Now, judiciary, third one, judiciary keeps check on the work of both the organs. If they are not working well or somebody doing any kind of crime, they would be punished by judiciary. So judiciary has power of doing judgments. Here are the judges of every court. Judges of every court comes under the judiciary. They have judicial powers. So these are the three main organs which comes under the parliamentary form of government. And now, control over the executive governments means, now I am going to explain this. Parliament is having Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, and Lok Sabha is having MPs, and Rajya Sabha is the upper house which have MLAs, member of legislative assembly. This is MLA means a member of legislative assembly, member of parliament. This is the full form of both. These ministers, MLA and MPs, are the work for the different kind of things. Now, first, what do parliament do here? The government is answerable to the parliament for its acts. Parliament is having right. Every government have to answer the parliament for their act. If whatever they do, they have to answer the parliament. If the government violate any law, if they deny to follow any law, any government or provision, a motion of the non-confidence is introduced, and if it is passed by the majority of the parliament, then the prime minister and council of minister have to resign. If they found, as I told you that impeachment process can be start for the ministers, this is the same process here explaining. If any minister or any council of minister found guilty and the law of no confidence passed, the majority of the parliament, then minister or the council of the minister have to resign. They have to resign from their post. Adjournment process, parliament is having another right, that is adjournment motion. Adjournment motion is, by this the current topic of discussion is postponed and the matter that need immediate attention of the government is taken up for the discussion. If there is any important issue came in the parliament and they are discussing on another thing, so parliament have right, or the presiding officer or the speaker have right to change or postpone the current matter, and they can immediately change the topic in the meeting, and they can take any immediate attention to the topic which is very needy for the meeting or country for that day. Another power of the execution of the parliament during the question hour. As I told you, the first hour in the parliament is in the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha is the question hour. Question hour is the in which the member of parliament means MP can ask questions from the government. MPs can ask questions from the government. The minister of the concerned department have to answer them. If I can give you an example. If there is a matter related with the financial things, financial things, and there is finance minister already available in the parliament, so the ministers can ask the question related to the finance. Then the concerned department minister, the minister of finance, can answer, or they have to answer to the MPs. Clear? The parliament may reduce the annual budget. Parliament also can reduce the annual budget if there is any crisis. Like these days, COVID-19 situation is going through. So parliament, by the next year, because all the economic activities have been stopped and so many other economic crises are there in the country. So what parliament can do? Parliament can reduce the annual budget also. By the next year, parliament can reduce the annual budget also for the country. The salaries and allowances are decided by parliament for the minister. Salaries and allowances of the ministers are decided by the parliament. For the ministers, their salary and allowances are decided by parliament also. Now, electoral powers. What are the electoral powers? Parliament plays an important role in elections of president and the vice president. Parliament also play an important role when there are election of president, the vice presidents. Note, what is annual budget? We discussed about annual budget. So here, in the annual financial report of India, an estimate of income and expenditure of the government on a periodical basis. Periodical basis means in every year, parliament or any government keeps check on the estimate of income, that how much income is coming in the country and how much our expenses. The government keeps on check on the this budget. This is called annual budget, and it keeps check on the every periodical basis, means every year or every 6 months. Now, comparison of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Now, there are so many works between the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. First of all, it is ordinary bill and money bills. So, they have different rights to pass them. Ordinary bills, it can be introduced in Lok Sabha and also in Rajya Sabha. Both the bills can be introduced in the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Ordinary bills, it can be introduced in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. When a bill is proposed, it goes through 3 readings. Any bill, when citizen amendment bill was there, citizen amendment bill, this is you called CAB, due to which many riots have been occurred in the month of January and February. For the Hindu Muslim riots were there in the Delhi and other states of the country. So this is called CAB. CAB. B means bill. But after some time it became CAA. How? Because this bill became a law and it became an act. When a bill passed and become a permanent law, it is called act. I think this is clear. So here, like, Citizen Amendment Bill, I am taking the example of Citizen Amendment Bill, CAB. When a CAB bill is proposed, it goes through the 3 readings. First is the introduction. First, the member of the council or the concerned member gave the introduction of the bill, then detailed discussion happened on this detailed discussion happened on this bill. After voting, after getting majority, it become an act. So there are the three main readings: introduction, detailed discussion, and voting. This is very important. It is then sent to the other house where a similar procedure is followed. This is where. Then after this reading from the lower house, it came to the other house, and where the similar process started, where the introduction, detail, discussion, and voting start, and the bill is passed in the both houses, it goes for the approval to the president. After this reading in the both the houses, this bill, any bill, but I'm taking example of the CAB. CAB go to the president, and the bill, an act or the law, when it is signed by the president. A bill become an act or law after the signing by president. Any bill become an act is after the sign by president. So here what happened? CAB became CAA. I hope आपको ये समझ आ गया होगा that firstly when you were reading this was CAB. After passing this bill as a law, it becomes CAA. Now money bills, I hope this is clear. Ordinary bills, these were the ordinary bills. Now money bills, money as the it announced with its name, money bills. A money bill can be introduced only in Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha have power to pass this money bill after three readings. Means what were the three readings? Were introduction, detailed discussion, and voting. After three readings, it is sent to the Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha has to pass the money bill within 14 days. Rajya Sabha has to pass this bill within 14 days. If they do not pass it in 14 days, it ultimately pass or approve with itself. After 14 days, itself passed. It doesn't need any pass or anything permission from the Rajya Sabha. If doesn't return bill within that time, the bill is deemed to have been passed by the Rajya Sabha. It is directly passed by the Rajya Sabha. In case of money bill, the Lok Sabha is more powerful. Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha. Money bill. In the case of money bill, Lok Sabha is more powerful than Rajya Sabha. Here, control over executive. It's the another function of the parliament. The houses, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, have equal rights of opportunity to ask questions and bring different kind of motion or changes against the government. Both the houses, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, have the right to and that they can bring any change. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha can bring any change or motions in against the government. If they don't like any work of the government, they can change or take motion in that particular work of government. Now, division of powers between the center and the states. Division of power between center. Now we are going to discuss division of powers between center and state. Center and state have different powers, as we discussed about union list, state list, and concurrent list. Constitution has clearly divided the power between center and state government. There are 28 states, so they are different kind of ministers, they are different kind of activities, they are different kind of land, the different kind of activities, economic activities. That is why constitution has divided the power between the center and the states to reduce the conflict between them. The legislative section is divided into three lists. Legislative section has been divided into three lists. There are union list, state list, and concurrent list. As we earlier discussed this, union list has 97 subjects, स्टेट लिस्ट हैज 66 सब्जेक्ट्स एंड 47 सब्जेक्ट्स कम्स अंडर द कॉन्करेंट लिस्ट. 97 सब्जेक्ट्स आर विच बिलोंग्स टू द नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल इम्पॉर्टेंस. इन विच 97 सब्जेक्ट्स आर फॉर द इंटरनेशनल इम्पॉर्टेंस. इट कैन वर्क फॉर द होल नेशन एंड इंटरनेशनल इम्पॉर्टेंस. एंड द 66 आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द स्टेट एंड लोकल इम्पॉर्टेंस लाइक एग्रीकल्चर ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर स्टेट, फॉरेस्ट, पब्लिक हेल्थ, सैनिटाइजेशन, ऑल सैनिटेशन और एवरी थिंग्स कम्स अंडर द ए पर्टिकुलर स्टेट और द लोकल गवर्नमेंट. Concurrent list, 47 subjects are there in which common interest of the both the union and the state government comes under this. 47 subjects, both can make laws on these subjects. 47 subjects are those subjects on which state list and union list, both can make laws. Both can make laws. This is called concurrent list. I hope this chapter is clear and this chapter is completed. Thank you and read it carefully.